Kaylee.
But as many times as I've had this dream, it's never been me before, holding the gun.
I know. It's very good. It implies a true, deeply rooted acceptance of responsibility. And it tells me that you haven't only overcome your delusion in your conscious mind, but in his subconscious mind as well. It's my opinion that Tim is a healthy adult who represents no danger to himself or anyone else. And I believe he should be discharged, as the state requested, on his upcoming 21st birthday.
Soul to the gentleman. Congratulations to you, sir. That's bidder number 131. All right, and our next item for bid is a gorgeous antique mirror recovered from the Levesque estate. The Lasser Glass is a well-traveled gem, spent several seasons adorning the walls at Balmoral Castle, Scottish home of the royal family. This is the original glass and the original frame. The mirror's in remarkable condition, save for a small hairline fracture down in the lower right-hand corner. The frame is carved out of one piece of Bavarian black cedar. And we will go ahead and start the bidding at a conservative $10,000. Do I have 10 right here in front? Thank you, sir.
Your sister's picking you up then.
Her message even said something about helping me find a job.
That'd be wonderful for your transition.
We're at $12,000 on the phones and back in the room.
You sure you don't want me to come with you? Just for moral support.
No, but thank you.
Do we have 14,
I think I better do this part myself.
Thank you, ma'am.
Wait up for us. 15,
of course.
Remember what we talked about. You've had a support system, a mandated support system to help you get well. Kaylee had to get by on her own. It's very important that you reconnect with your sister. But it's more important that you protect your recovery.
$16,000
on Skype. That is 16 going once. 16 twice. Sold. Please pass along our congratulations. Little brother.
You're half of the estate.
Oh, apartments. So all the studies say that you should transition to a place that isn't necessarily large, so I printed off some listings for studios, but
in the meantime, until you find one you like, we would love it if you stayed with us.
Kaylee, I don't know how to thank you.
Well, I wanted to talk to you about all of this sooner. Suddenly, they wouldn't let me in to see you.
It wasn't that they wouldn't let you in to see me. I just had some things I needed to figure out for myself.
I'm your family. The only thing that matters is that you're here now. Okay. I found it.
What do you mean?
You know, it wasn't easy. I tracked it down mostly through second bidders. people who lost at the auctions. It was in storage, part of an estate collection in Bremen. It took me a year and a half to get it into our warehouse, and it lasted less than a week. It's about to ship out to a new buyer, so we only have a few days. That should be enough.
A few days for what, Kaylee?
To keep our promise. And kill it.
Okay, guys, the couch can go there, and those boxes are kitchen.
Timbo, don't shoot the movers.
And as soon as I get my files organized, you will have them. Yes. Shh. Can I call you back? Jeff, I am so sorry I didn't return your call. Listen, I've just been slammed. It's a lot easier when you have a staff.
Kaylee's under arrest.
She's not here, buddy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, you are so
hey, guys,
dead.
Guys. Honey?
No.
And this goes? Okay. Against the wall. All right. Watch the molding.
Thank you.
You were like
okay.
Covering it.
Now
and then it went
off,
and I heard it.
Always,
you always just
like,
just my guys, take it outside.
But mom,
the alternative is moving boxes. Oh.
Sorry. Oh, yeah, no. So we'll talk soon. Okay.
Thanks, guys. Yeah, great. Okay. I'll be right out. So you expanded the furniture order?
I don't know if I'm loving this desk here.
Were you gonna tell me, or just wait till I saw the visa bill?
Hold on. I was hoping to smooth that over with a three-piece vanity set that is supposed to be here. Is it not here?
I get it. Okay, do your office however you want.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. It's a bit ostentatious, though, don't you think?
Well, I'm confused, because you wanted the antiques, and I said I was fine with IKEA, so...
Yeah, I wanted to get a few pieces to upgrade the place, not turn it into a showroom.
Well, listen, we got a new home, new company, so we get new furniture. Makes sense.
Same old wife, though, right?
Well, I told you I was fine with IKEA. Kidding.
I'm not IKEA. You sure you prefer this? You know, our guest room is a lot nicer than this.
Yeah, I think it might be best. My own space.
You promised me you'd never forget what really happened. You promised.
I was 10 years old.
Well, I'm doing it tomorrow night, and I could really, really use your help. Good night, Tim. My scar is more noticeable now than it was 10 years ago.
Let me take a look. I'm a professional. What scar?
We're nowhere near done.
So?
You've only put together the bed.
That wasn't easy.
great tears. It's okay. So I requisitioned you your own printer. You don't have to share anymore.
I'll take you off the network.
Okay.
Because I guess there were some complaints about people printing out their sales reports and finding some really graphic crime scene photos from your computer. I noticed you put in a transfer order for the laser glass.
Yeah, that's a repair.
I thought Warren said no repairs.
We changed his mind.
Gotta be honest, I'm really just waiting for an explanation for the corpse printouts.
I know things have been strange at times. And you know I'm dealing with some dark stuff, some parental stuff with Tim out. I'll never expect you to understand that part of my life. Just bear with me a day or two more. Things will get back to normal. I promise.
I don't usually get transfer orders to third-party repair houses.
Oh, the buyer wants his guy to look at it before it ships. But we both know you'd do it better.
No argument there.
I'll take it there myself. Babysit it every step of the way.
Better get some ferny pads if we're gonna move her.
Hello again. You must be hungry.
You're all set. You all right?
I'm great.
The guys will wrap her up for you in a bit.
Thank you, Warren. I'll see you at home.
My car's by the loading dock. Hello.
Hey. Got a phone.
Cool.
You just need to sign the order.
I don't feel good about the way we left it last night. Can we meet up somewhere and talk?
Of course. Can you come by the house?
Sure. What's your address?
No. The house.
Yes, I have it in front of me. I don't know, probably a half an hour. Does that work? Okay. Speak then.
The answer is still no.
Oh my God, Ellie has one and Maddie has one. I'm the only kid in my class without a phone.
That is terrible.
Thanks for nothing, Marie.
Oh, I'm gonna run out and get one for you right now, daughter. Love of my life, fruit of my loins.
Well, I wish I'd been a pineapple.
Hey kids, do me a favor and don't ever chew your nails like your father.
Hey, Dad.
Oh, okay. He's Dad. I'm Marie.
Who's that lady in your office today?
Yeah, Dad. Who is that lady in your office today?
What lady?
I don't know, just some lady.
I don't know.
Small.
Come on, dog.
You named your dog Dog?
He doesn't have a name. Are you okay? Oh, of course. You haven't been here since. Why don't you look around? Just sat on the market while I was in the foster system. Released me when I turned 18.
I was the only homeowner in the freshman dorms when I started school. I'm thinking we should try and sell it, though. You know, after. So will you help me with something before you go?
How the hell did you expect to get this thing in here yourself?
To be honest, I didn't. I always thought it'd be both of us. Over here for now.
What's that?
Yacht anchor. Kill switch. So, I understand if you don't want to stay. I accept that, but I gotta get started.
I'll stay for a little bit.
Hello. My name is Kaylee Ann Russell. I'm 23 years old. I'm with my brother, Timothy Allen Russell. Allen, of course, after his father. He's 21 years old. It's 4:15 p.m. on October 13th, and we are at 2705 Hawthorne Way. I'll begin by detailing my precautions before I place and uncover the glass. There are three cameras, each on its own independent power circuit, so if any anomalies occur, there can be a lucid objective record. I have private landlines for today's experiment along with my cell phone, and I will now ask my brother for his phone so that I can control all electronic devices.
I just got this, you know.
Thanks, Jimbo. This alarm is set to go off every 45 minutes to remind me to change the tapes in the cameras. This alarm is set to go off hourly to remind us to eat. And we're fully stocked on water to prevent dehydration. And as for the house itself, each room is fitted with its own thermostat from which data is collected by software designed to track and record temperature fluctuations in hospitals. Any temperature changes greater than 5 degrees in either direction will set off an alarm. A third precaution is also in place, but I'll get into that in a few more minutes. So, the purpose of today's experiment is to prove that the object behind me, the lesser glass, is home to an observable, predictable, supernatural force. There's no scientific equivalent for the word haunted, so we'll just say this object is responsible for at least 45 deaths in the 4 centuries of its recorded existence.
Can I just stop you for a second?
No. Don't ever turn off a camera.
Sorry.
The origin of the Lasser Glass is unknown, so I can't provide a complete history, but the trail starts in London in 1754. Philip Lasser, the 17th Earl of Leicester, acquired the mirror and hung it over his fireplace. And another precaution. Hi, sweetie, how are you?
Well, I'm checking in, as requested.
You all right?
Everything's fine. Oh, I know this is silly to ask, but could you try and call on the hour? It's about 7 past.
Sure.
I'll talk to you in 53 minutes, and I love you. I'm expecting regular calls from my fiancé, Michael Dumont. I told him I'm nervous to be spending time with my recently unincarcerated brother with instructions to notify the authorities immediately if I do not answer the phone.
In the room.
Nothing personal. So in 1755, Philip Lasser was found at their grand fireplace, burned beyond recognition.
While his estate was dismantled and scattered throughout southern England, one of the family's stewards claimed to see Philip reflected in the mirror, an allegation apparently taken seriously enough to warrant a church investigation into the house. The glass, thereafter known as the Lasser Glass, is sold in public auction in 1758. The next known owner is an American railroad tycoon named Robert Clancy, 1864. Clancy apparently weighed over 300 pounds. In fact, while attending university in Connecticut, he was known as the South Windham Whale.
He hung the glass in his ballroom in Atlanta. Later that year, Robert Clancy is photographed by a local newspaper and, well, he's dropped a few pounds. His obit was printed a few weeks later. Doesn't list a cause of death. Unfortunately, he and his estate and the glass are presumably destroyed in Sherman's March to the Ocean in 1865. And after that, the glass is lost until it resurfaces in turn-of-the-century New England. The next case of note is Mary O'Connor, 1904. She hung the mirror in her private bathroom. 2 weeks later, her niece Beatrice finds Mary dead in the bathtub. Now, the official coroner's report lists the cause of death as, get this, dehydration. The woman died of thirst while soaking in a full tub for 3 days. The next case of note is Alice Carden in Lake Geneva, Wisconsin, 1943. Neighbors reported hearing screams and loud bangs from the house. The police found the children drowned in a locked cistern. Alice herself was in the nursery, and both of her legs are completely shattered. Her left arm is broken in 4 places, and 6 of her ribs are crushed. In her right hand is a large hammer she's been using to break her own bones. And they find her just as she's going to work on her skull. Her right arm, though, is completely unharmed, because she needed it to wield a hammer. Alice later says she believed she was tucking the children into their beds as she sealed them in the cistern. She never recovers from her injuries. And oh, the family kept several dogs at the farm, including an Australian shepherd for the children. Let's eat.
Who exactly are you talking to on those tapes?
All the people who stared, pointed, the kids at school who always found out. I guess I'm talking to everyone who ever called Dad a murderer. Called you a murderer.
Look, Kaylee, we were just kids. We made up a scary story so we wouldn't have to accept the fact that our father was a murderer. He was. He was a sick man who tortured and killed our...
You can call me crazy all you like. But you're not allowed to talk about him that way. Tobin Kapp, 1955. Starved to death in his own bedroom. The mirror was hung over his dresser. He had a pet Dalmatian. 1965, California. The mirror hangs in the lobby of the Hill Trust Bank in San Diego. A 10-year teller, Marsha Wicker, locks her manager in a bank vault and then chews through a live power line. 1975, Marisol Chavez dies in her bedroom of hemorrhaging due to a miscarriage. In her nightstand, they find every single one of her teeth in a little plastic bag and a pair of bloody pliers. 2002.
You know, there's a huge difference between causation and correlation.
I know the difference, thank you.
Okay, then in 2001, Mom and Dad bought that new couch. Same year, Grandpa had a heart attack, Robbie Schultz got hit by a car, and our cat ran away. How much of that do you blame on that couch?
Can I get back to this now?
Sure, but let's get to it, Kaylee. Let's talk about why we're really here.
2002. The lacquer glass adorns the home office of Alan Russell, software designer, husband to Marie, father to Timothy and Kaylee. Within 2 weeks of its arrival, Marie suffers an intense psychological breakdown and is tortured and murdered in the family home.
By whom? By her husband.
So say the police reports.
And her husband was shot to death by her own son. Right in front of her daughter.
I intend to prove that none of the people I've just described were responsible for their actions. Alan Russell was not a murderer, he was a victim. One of many, as it turns out, victims of the supernatural force that resides in that mirror.
So why don't we just end it right now and smash the goddamn thing?
You really don't remember, do you?
Remember what?
Please, smash it. By all means.
Okay. You know, I've learned a lot about what happens to people when they can't process something horrible.
The mind creates all kinds of protections to help them cope.
And once that belief's taken root, the mind takes random information and forces it to support that narrative. How many thousands of records did you have to pour through to find 12 or 13 that support your case?
Why did you put the stool down?
Because I'm trying to have a conversation with you.
Uh-huh. Only one person I know of was ever documented trying to break the mirror. Oliver Jeffries, 1971, a teacher at Manhattan's Duhame Academy, where the mayor hung the central lecture hall. One morning, he reportedly ran at the mayor with a fireplace poker, shouting about how it needed to be destroyed, but he never struck a blow. According to his students, he stood there quietly for almost a minute before walking out of the hall and into traffic. It's clearly capable of defending itself, and I think it just disarmed you.
You know why I didn't smash the mirror, Kaylee? Besides you getting fired or charged with destruction of property, it isn't mine to break. No one can break your delusion for you. You have to do it yourself.
Which leads me to my final precaution. You're looking at a 20-pound Danforth anchor. Another 20 pounds added with barbells attached to a modified ballast rail and a spring pin lock connected to a mechanical kitchen timer. No electricity, which is important, and we're about 10 seconds away. The timer is not manually reset every 30 minutes. That is if no one is here to stop it. The mirror goes right there. And the only thing to prevent that from happening again is our continued survival. So you know why we don't have to wait for it to come out and play? Because we got a loaded gun to its head. And I expect it'll be eager to defend itself.
Guys, come into my office for a second. I thought I was pretty clear about you guys not messing around in here.
We don't. I don't like it in here.
All right, well, what is this?
We didn't do that.
Okay. You know, I can hear you guys at night messing around in here. I was a kid once too, I get it. I know the move has been difficult. This isn't gonna happen anymore, okay? And if you're messing around with your mother's plants, you're gonna cut that out too.
You know what dead plants are evidence of to me? Problems with the water supply, maybe a bad tank. I seem to remember drinking out of a Brita filter.
Oliver Jeffries, dead plants in the classroom. Tobin Cap, dead plants in the bedroom. Garden service at Hilltrust Bank couldn't understand why they had dead plants all over the place.
Live plant. Live plants in the living room. Live plant, plants that have life. These are your rules, by the way.
Give it time. It always starts with the low-hanging fruit. It wasn't just the plants it fed on, though. There was another variable, too. Dog! Sorry, dog. Hydrate.
Come on, boy.
Come on, Mason. Go
come
fetch.
On. Mason.
Go fetch.
Chase a stick. Oh, chase a stick.
Come on. Go.
I mean, the whole reason I got this thing was because you were all freaked out that we weren't safe. You said you saw somebody down here.
Yeah, but that doesn't make me feel safer. Quite the opposite, actually.
Okay, I will lock it up, unloaded, where I'm sure it'll come in very handy in the case of an emergency. Grotesque cow.
What did you just say to me?
I didn't say anything.
Who are you talking to?
Were you gonna do something about the damn barking? There's something wrong with the dog, Alan. He bit me.
Are you okay?
I'm fine. I just... You know, you are just lost in your own world in here.
I'm not lost in my own... Guys, listen, you gotta do me a special favor today. I have a golf session with a client, and I'm gonna need you to stay out of my office, okay?
Okay, Dad.
All right, I love you guys.
Says Mason's grounded.
Hey, Squirts. Why are you,
We have got to do something about that damn dog.
A hello would be nice.
He was a wrecking ball all day. I had to lock him in your office.
Well, tether him up.
Where is he?
Well, there's the problem. You're remembering it wrong.
I promise. I'm not remembering it wrong.
You are, though. Mason...
Alice Carden's Australian Shepherd. Tobin Capp's Dalmatian. The pets were never found. None of them.
Do you remember Mason toward the end? Vomiting, accidents all over the house. My therapist had me research parvo virus.
Oh,
it's a fatal canine illness flagged by nausea, aggression, infected urine, and stool, which, incidentally, can kill plants. Mason was sick.
All right, I'll take him to the vet tomorrow.
Bad news. I don't think we're both coming home.
Mom, where's Mason?
He's grounded. Are you saying you remember it happening that way? Are you really saying that?
Why not?
You're wrong. I saw Mom lock him in the office, and I sat outside that door all day, and nobody went in or out.
Have you ever heard of the fuzzy trace theory of human psychology?
No, but I'm gonna guess you have.
I'm the star of a psychiatric article about it. Our brains actually encode information as fuzzy traces, more like a general meaning than an exact record.
This is horseshit, Tim.
And adults are more likely to combine those traces into false memories. You saw Mom put the dog in the office on a number of occasions.
My God, what did they do to you?
Way before Dad forbade anyone else from going in the office, those traces fused with your memory of that day.
I feel sorry for you.
Okay, what's more likely? That you're misremembering events from 11 years ago, or that the mirror eats dogs? Oh, look, it's Dog.
Give it some time. A little time.
Sorry that we woke you up.
Are you and Daddy fighting because of the woman in the office?
You gotta remember that woman. You saw her too.
I convinced myself I saw a lot of things. But what do we really see? Mom yelling at Dad in the middle of the night. Mom said she heard voices, but it was probably just Dad on the phone.
Doesn't explain the woman I saw through the window.
But when did you see her?
First time, we were playing in the yard.
Was Mom at home?
Mom was always home.
Are you sure about that? Because I'm not. He was having an affair, saint that he was. It was a bad marriage. Look how it ended up.
No.
Our father was a cheater, and it drove our mother crazy.
Stop it.
He snapped and he killed her. Was gonna do the same to us.
Oh, yeah. A bad marriage. That explains how Mom had no teeth, no hair, no mind left by the time she died.
Kaylee, you...
Yeah, a bad marriage. That explains those other people we both saw in the house that last night.
He was withdrawn, secretive, all signs of an affair.
I had access to all of Mom and Dad's stuff. While you were getting brainwashed, I looked, and not one credit card receipt, phone call, flower order, nothing to suggest an affair.
You're smart enough not to leave a trail.
Quiet! I talked to his friends and his co-workers. If there was another woman, she was a ghost. And yeah, I agree, he was withdrawn and secretive, suspicious. Sure, all signs of an affair, fine. I'm not saying he wasn't seduced. It's a matter of what seduced him. And things have been happening in here while we argue, you know? You know, the temperature in here has risen by 3 degrees. 3 degrees.
Two people in a small space, lights burning, electrical equipment,
and
I don't know.
The phone lines are probably down by now. Why don't you check?
Okay, then. Let's have a look. Dial tone.
Static?
Look, Kaylee, you can deal with this. I did it. You want to redeem the family name? You don't need to do it for Mom and Dad. You only need to do it for yourself.
Oh. They did a bang-up job on you in there, didn't they? You were perfectly normal when they locked you up. You gotta go batshit to get out. And Mason, stop your goddamn whining!
You know what? That's it. I'm done. I know I'm supposed to wait around for you to find your own way out of this, but I'm not gonna stand here and let you torture a dog.
What do you think you're doing?
Listen to it!
Stop it! Stop it!
What?
You didn't need to do
that. Oh, yes, I did, Kaylee. You're sick. Nothing you've said would happen tonight has happened. The plants are still alive. The mirror is just the mirror. And the only thing threatening that dog was you. And it's not your fault. Like, it wasn't my fault. I had help, and you were alone. These kinds of problems are hard to overcome, but they're nothing to be ashamed of. They run in our family. Kaylee, I'm sorry. Look, let's get out of here. Go someplace else and talk about how to move on.
Where can we go?
Let's go turn off those cameras, disarm that anchor, and we can go anywhere you want. Go talk to your fiance, maybe. He'll want to help, you know he will. Kaylee?
There it is. There it is.
I'm now reviewing the tape of the last few minutes.
He was having an affair. Same thing he was. It was a bad marriage. Look how it ended up.
No.
Our father was a cheater, and it drove our mother crazy.
Stop it.
He snapped and he killed her. It was going to do the same twice.
Yeah, bad marriage. That explains how mother no teeth, no hair, no mind left by the time she died.
Kaylee!
Yeah, a bad marriage. That explains those other people we both saw in the house that last night.
I don't remember doing that. Do you? You don't. And the temperature in the room has increased another 2 degrees to 78 degrees Fahrenheit, but the alarms didn't go off, which means, oh boy. Okay, we've lost the ficus and the blooming plants, which tells me that the dog provided at least enough energy to bait the shark.
I gotta call the doctor.
Tim, if you're gonna make a phone call, you need to do it outside its radius of influence. Otherwise, there's no way of knowing who you're really talking to. Hello? Hi, yeah. Everything's fine now. I'm sorry about earlier, and I'll talk to you in an hour. 50-50, that was you and him. We need to get out of this room for a while. Must have gotten more from the dog than I guessed. Its radius of influence appears to be 30 feet, which means we're still gonna go in the kitchen, laundry room, garage, master bedroom, and the yard, front and back. Oh, but I doubt for very long. Tim? Tim!
Your call cannot be completed as dialed. Please check your call cannot be completed as dialed. Please check the number and dial again. Your call cannot be completed as dialed. Please check the number and dial again. Your call cannot
Tim.
Be completed as dialed. And dial again.
Tim.
How did I get back in here?
What do you mean? You walked over here and you sat down.
I was outside.
No, you weren't. Did you think you were? Would you mind saying that on camera? Hey, it's because you're still here that I know we're gonna win. Do you hear me? Do you understand?
Daddy coming home?
I don't know.
You don't know when Daddy's coming home?
I don't know where he is.
I know where he says he is. Kaylee. Tell me more about the woman in the office.
I haven't seen her.
I have.
When?
Last night. She wasn't in the office. She was on the stairs.
What was she doing?
I didn't look. I was scared. But I think she went back in the office. I think she lives there.
You two go upstairs and play.
sweetheart. You gotta go back in your room.
Mommy.
Your mother's fine. She's okay. She's gonna be all right. Just please go back inside. Shut the door, okay, baby? Yeah, I have an emergency with my wife.
Tim,
snap out of it.
Are you here with me? Tim.
Guys, your mother is very, very sick. And she's gonna need to stay in bed for a while to rest up so she can get better. But we don't want you to bothering her.
We?
So, champ, princess, you're gonna have to stay clear of that room. Is that understood?
What does she have?
Now, you are welcome to hang out in here and play video games.
I thought you said we weren't allowed in here.
Eat. Come on, I need your help.
Tim! Tim, snap out of it! Tim! Is that for Mom?
Nice. Oh.
hungry, Kaylee.
You need to go grocery shopping, Dad.
What's that, Princess?
Food.
That's on my list.
The TV is out.
What's that, Princess?
We need to call a doctor for Mom.
That's on my list.
This is stupid. I'm gonna tell her we're out of food.
But Dad said
I don't care what Dad said.
You not to go into our room, didn't I? What do? You disobey me. Why? You disobey me, so now you get grounded. You and your snot-nosed little brother over there are not to step foot outside of this house. Now get out of here.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
What did the doctor say?
He said to have her father call.
Like the last one.
Exactly like the last one. Same voice.
Really sorry to hear that. I hope she gets better soon.
Thanks for that, Bob. You know, I'm just sorry she brought you all the way over here. I mean, she's, you know, using her mother's illness to act out. And...
Wait till she starts driving. This is nothing. Well, so sorry to bother you. I hope Marie's up and about soon.
Thank you. Hey, you know what? Give me a ring next week and we'll play the front nine at Arrowhead.
Great. We'll do it. See ya.
Take care.
We're gonna have to get really, really brave.
Kaylee?
And we've lost electric. Predictable. Dead plant.
Daddy? You fix the lights?
Tricks. Hello.
Just checking in, seeing how everything's going.
I'm fine.
Okay. Guess I'll talk to you in an hour. Enjoyed the chat.
That's a trick. I didn't kill him. I couldn't have. The plate, it wasn't real. I didn't kill him because the plate wasn't real.
Hello? I need police and an ambulance, 2705 Hawthorne. Okay. Help is coming. They'll be here, we'll straighten all this out. Kaylee, we're okay. We're okay.
Michael.
When was the last time you reset the kitchen timer?
I don't know.
Your plan was solid. We don't have to do anything. All we have to do is just sit here and wait. No more than half an hour. Your kill switch.
You called for help?
Yeah. We're done. It's over. We get to stand here and watch that thing die.
The trick to get us back inside.
This is the trick to keep us standing there.
I called for help.
Call again.
What's your emergency?
Yeah, hi, I just called 2705 Hawthorne.
You're going to have your father call. The doctor will be there tomorrow. The doctor will be there tomorrow.
What do we do?
We could do nothing. Just wait.
Watch ourselves get...
We're gonna have to get really, really brave.
The mirror and took out a gun. We're gonna have to smash it.
Kaylee?
was never here. It just herded us upstairs. We made the right call outside. It's really trying to keep us away. It'll try harder. We have to get downstairs before that anchor swings.
You have to make sure he's gone first.
He's gone. I promise. See?
Gotta get downstairs.
She's not gone.
I can open the door.
No.
I can open the door. If she's not gone, we'd run right down the stairs.
What are you gonna do?
Don't worry about that. Just run. You ready? I can open the door.
Just a trick.
You gonna arrest me, Timbo?
Timbo.
Him? Yep.
Mommy.
Promise me that when we're big and we're strong, we will make this right. We have to kill that thing. For Mom and Dad.
He called in?
Yeah, he called 911. And then he did this.
Where are you taking me? No, it wasn't my fault! It was the mirror!
Let's go! It wasn't me! It wasn't me! It was the mirror! It was the mirror!
Please, you have to believe me!
It was the mirror!